The next slide. We have been installing since the beginning of the 1 million genome initiative a mirror group. And in Belgium, I must say, as the 1 million genomes aims both research and health, the research is in generally, the majority of research is financed by our regional organizations, the regional states, and we have representation of them, at least for the Flemish region, it's Katelijne-Dont, and Katelijne-Dont is also a major player in the RTD, EC RTD world, and we had Sophie Peterbroek for the French-speaking part. So we were three, and I was taking care a little bit of the health aspects. We organized several meetings with the, let's say, the main players in Belgium that would be interested in genomics, which is some of the university groups, many people from the rare diseases, some cancer people, and a number of population-driven institutes. And then also we had representatives from some of the officials, the governmental bodies, and some of the charities. It was around 40, 50, 60 people that were in our mirror group. We actually worked for, let's say, 1.5 to 2 years on a regular basis with them. But then the EBCP came in, and then also we started in Belgium with a particular project that was called the Belgian Human Genome. And then I must say the mirror group has, let's say, lost a little bit of its importance, because that's also something I see with ABCP. Once the national implementation comes in, you turn away from the European side and you go to the national side. Now, just some elements that we already did in Belgium on genomics. With healthcare aspects, the next step is the first thing was, in fact, we tried to link genomics information to what we are doing already in our institute for more than 25 years, is the health interview survey. So the health interview survey is a survey on general health of the population on a representative sample. So more than 10,000 participants are being interviewed. And in 2012-13, we asked for money to do a small pilot. We recontacted people from the health interview of 2013, and we did some array mapping just to demonstrate, to figure out whether we were allowed, whether the Privacy Commission would agree, whether the ethic committees would agree. And we did the first analysis on the distribution of SNPs in the different regions. In the next slide, we build on that further. And there is the thinking now on having a real cohort, a population cohort. And our colleagues from Cienzano are thinking of a cohort of more than 30,000 people. But within the health interview survey of 2018, we did the first, what they then call a health examination survey. So meaning that you take some samples and especially blood, and you also do some general measurements of the physical health of the people. And from these samples, we are now having already 100 sequenced whole genome. And it's the idea to bring them also, Andre, into the genome of Europe and extend that to about 1,000 samples from a representative sample from the Belgian population. And then in the next phase, we would gradually build that up into this cohort. We are still looking on how we can complete the full 10,000 people that should fit in the genome of Europe. There are a number of cohorts that fit, but it's often very difficult to link the informed consents and the aims of the cohorts with the genome of Europe. So we're doing that together with our colleagues from Leuven. And so we're working on that to make sure that we can start to do individual level data linkages. And that's, I'd say, from the public health genomic sites, that's the main interest that we are now doing in Belgium. The next slide is showing then what a linkage study that we also would like to use as a use case in the GDI, where we have linked the small whole genome sequencing or where we intend to link the whole genome sequencing coming from the HIS-HES with data from the cancer register, and also with, of course, some of the administrative data that we have available. Now, the Health Data Survey is a very rich data. I think there are more than 700 variables available on the general health of the person. And we know that in our small sample, there are a number of people who have reported that they had cancer. Now, the data date from 2018. So by now, I think there are even in the small sample more people that will have developed cancer. And the idea is to look a little bit at predisposition of cancer and whether we can figure out some of the predictive models, whether they fit or correlate with what we have in our small data set. The next slide is on the Belgian Genome Biobank. So when we were hearing that the genome of Europe would come up, our colleagues from Leuven, together with us and a number of other parties that are directly interested in setting up the genomics biobank, a human genomics biobank, we introduced a project for the research funders in Flanders, and we obtained that some money to that. And that's the next slide. And the idea is now that based on the data, the samples that we have at the different biobanks to come up and try to complete the genome of Europe. We do not have enough funding. We only received, I think, if I remember well, about 1 million for sequencing. But André, with the money that we will get from the genome of Europe, we will gradually build it up and then try to complete the genome of Europe. And the genome of Europe would then be directly linked into the initiatives that I saw that Bruno is here with the EDIC, and make sure that we can, at least through the EDIC, give access also to use of this data set in the GDI. So the next slide is, I took an old slide. I think it's not completely adequate because some of the data sets will probably not be available. Also, the thinking on the long read sequencing is probably too optimistic. We decided that is not going to be, but it's something that is going on. So I think the primary intention now in Belgium is to come to a full operational Genome of Europe data set. And then in the next slide, you can see that there is already quite some activity and genetic testing in Belgium, both in the rare diseases, where genetic centers are already doing for quite some time complex genomics testing, so genome-wide testing. It may be microarrays, it's exons, but they also already do a whole genome sequencing. And also in cancer, we are starting to have broad panels being used. And there is already some thinking, and I heard, I think it was Frederick saying, in pediatric cancers, I think there is also interest to start thinking on doing whole genome sequencing. So in the next slide is a compilation of where do we go with the medicine plan. And I must say that the fact that Europe has been launching the idea to create a European data infrastructure consortium has raised to some of the politicians urge that we should do something on a genomics medicine plan. But in Belgium, in general, we have to come with sufficient evidence before we can move into such an initiative. If it's the federal government that has to drive it, then it has to be health-driven. And for that, I was very glad that in the CanHeal project, we came up with some, let's say, an assessment model that allows us also to see whether a particular intervention, which would be now the whole genome sequencing, could already be readily implemented in the healthcare system and with the different elements. The next slide, Domenico also introduced the maturity level assessment that was done in the B1MG. We participated on that. And I think there, one of the things that is really an essential point for our healthcare officials is that, in fact, we lack dramatically genetic counseling in Belgium. So we have to take that up, because that will be one of the barriers that will be identified if we want to go forward with genomics medicine. I think it will be even probably larger than health technology assessment, because I'm quite convinced that in a number of indications, definitely in the rare diseases, but also in cancer, we will have enough evidence to say that it can be reimbursed in a cost-effective way. As somebody indicated already, people are now combining multiple tests, and it's probably cheaper for the moment to do whole genome sequencing. And then in the last slide, at the EU presidency meeting, our Minister of Health has demanded our health technology assessment body to create a framework, especially to identify unmet needs in the Belgian healthcare system, and then starting from there to build up a model that allows you to see what different steps should be taken. I must say, I have looked already at the model, and it's probably very, very specific. It's maybe too specific. So we have to discuss with our colleagues from the KC how we can adapt it to the questions that we would have in how to introduce and bring forward whole genome sequencing in the healthcare system. Definitely, the combination of the three models would help us to support and getting support from the federal, and I'm sure from the research level also. I'm also sure that there will be some discussions between the different levels. Some of you may know that we are in the process of building the new governments. I think in some cases it may go fast, but at least at the federal level, it may take a little bit more discussion. Knowing that there is also elections still on the city level, the township level in October. But anyway, the next slide tried to put everything a little bit together. Central point for the genomics is going to be this genome of Europe. We will link it probably somewhere to the cancer register for cancer. We have to link it to socioeconomic elements. We would like to also include the healthcare system, so the summary EHR has to be in. And then, of course, you have all the regulatory elements that come in. You have the Data Protection Act, you have the Health Data Agency, which in Belgium is not an authority, so it's two different bodies to make it possible to link to the European health data space. And then I'm very glad to say that at least at the federal level, there is already endorsement to support the EDIC. And I think that will be now the driver in the coming months and year to really set us on the road to develop a genomics medicine plan. And I'm very glad that we have here some very nice examples from our colleagues in France. And I am aware also from the German side. So we will build on that to write out probably in the couple of 6, 7 months to come the Belgian medical plan or the way towards a medical plan. And I think that is more or less my last slide.